Okay, I'm back. I'm still here. Gonna get back into it here and start on some writing. Hopefully get into a groove right now. That will groove me right into the thousand words before 9 o'clock. So, let's put all of my ducks in rows and start looking at some stuff. Now, I've got to write about Copilot. I've already started writing about Copilot. In the previous chapter, but I didn't really go into history of it, what it is, where it is. And so this is the part where I kind of have to look at documentation on GitHub, get some screenshots of it, and then talk about plans and what it can do, why, how, what model it uses, and give some examples. So it's kind of maybe I start by looking at like They've got like a billion of them. I'm not going to list all of JetBrains' IDEs. I think I can just say JetBrains' IDEs. Suggestions as you code. Suggestions are based on get their context. Copilot generates suggestions using context from your current the document, the file you're currently working on. Editor, and does it take from the repository as well? How exactly Yeah. This is all going to be different when this thing actually, when this book is finished and ready to be published. Everything's going to be different. So I have to speak in like as vague terms and sort of anticipate. And I think it also uses now, or will shortly. Okay, so it's saying vector database. So what is this vector database? It's a database that indexes high dimensional vectors. As well as this writing. What's that date on here? Yeah, May 2023. That is working on. No, actually, we can say just your public repositories. From how many? Millions. Millions of public GitHub repositories. Publicly available source code. And I can say, although Copilot works best with Python, there was something I was just reading about which languages it works best with. Oh, there we go. JavaScript, TypeScript, Ruby, and Go. It has been trained on source code from over a dozen programming languages. Should continue to become more doing pretty all right here today. It's starting to see, this is essential stuff, but relatively boring. And since I wrote this outline, it seems like chat in Copilot has become standard. So I want to look into that. Yeah, so the GitHub, 6 days ago, GitHub Copilot chat beta now available to all individuals. So I can talk about Copilot chat because it's going to be available to everyone. And it is installed by default when you install it. So that's better, because 2 weeks ago I tried to use chat, but it said, oh, you need to be on a waiting list. No more waiting list, it's just there. It's really handy, actually, and so I can use that now. And so I need to update my outline based on the fact that chat exists for everyone now. And fine-tuning settings, I don't know how many settings there really are for Copilot, just kind of does things. But we'll find out. And so I can put in these line breaks here so that my outline doesn't keep jumping. Let's do that. Now I've got some room. And this, we already did in chapter one. So I think what I can do here, kind of repeat myself a little bit, but then reference what I did in chapter one. I wonder if it's called extensions in other IDEs. So let's look at NeoVim. I've never used NeoVim. Plugins, it's called plugin. So it's extension in VS Code, it's plugin in NeoVim. So NeoVim is just a new version of Vim. Well, let's go there. Something out here. Okay, cool. So it's installing like everything. What have you done? Okay, well, let's just try it. So I probably need to add it to my path, but wouldn't Shouldn't homebrew do that? Oh, might not work on Apple Silicon. Super important. Right, it's not yet ported. It's not there. It should be NVIM. Not a directory. Wait, I did. Oh, so yeah, it's a file. Okay. So if I just do. Let's just try running it. Okay. Oh, darn it, give me that help back. Okay, I'm not going to explain in my book how to install plugins with NeoVim. So this might be just kind of a goofball exercise in me geeking out, but I'll check this out later. be found? Yeah. You can find the instructions. Thank you, Strunk and White. Installing Copilot. Remember. Use Copilot. Oh, there we go. Let's make sure that's correct. It looks like it. It'll be interesting when the book comes out and these prices aren't the same, but we'll find out just how different they are. It's kind of interesting to document it now and then. Or this might get cut from the book just because it's probably going to be useless information when they raise the prices in a bit, a couple months. Let's see what settings there are, because the next section is called fine-tuning settings, but I'm not really positive that there are many possible settings. Ooh, I probably should switch to the pre-release version. The pre-release version is going to, of course, get us closer to what readers of the book we'll be working with, I'm hoping. Okay, so I could I mean, it's not really, there's not many settings. Oh, so pre-release version is not a beta version. Got it. It's an earlier version. That's a good feature. Okay, so it comes with that. That's fine. So we don't have a heck of a lot of settings to configure here. Take another break here. So much coffee. Okay. So these are the only settings there are, so I can't really have a section of the book saying, you can turn it on and off in the settings. So that section needs to go away. But I wonder if the chat has some settings. Nope. Wonder if Labs has some settings. Hmm. buttons above the focused function. Okay, so, functions to generate tests for can be selected with a code lens. A couple things here, but that's certainly not worth a whole section. Now there are some other plugins that maybe we could talk about. Well, here's what I'm gonna do. I've been going without a break here for 50 minutes. It's time definitely for a break. And I wonder if in terms of viewers, it's better to just leave things open when I go for a break, and then people can sit here and watch my screen for a while, or to just sign off. I don't care. I'm gonna stop streaming. I'll be back in half an hour.